Good morning. Good morning, my beautiful, lovely people. Happy Thursday. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. And if I must add, my mother's favorite quote is, God is great and greatly to be praised. Good morning, y'all. So, let me tell y'all, before I start this morning devotion, your girl should be asleep right now. I still probably should be asleep, but I got up, I pushed my way. I'm like, you gotta get up. Morning devotion is supposed to be early in the morning. And I usually do the morning devotion like when I'm at work, because, you know, I'm at work, it's early. But when I'm at home, I'm on vacation, y'all. So I will try to stay in the bed, stay asleep, but I'm looking like, no, Melissa, no. The morning devotion is supposed to be early. You're supposed to get your morning devotion early in the morning, first thing in the morning, not late at evening in the morning. So your girl, I might be a little tired, but I'm going to get what needs to be done, because your girl was up from late last night. I was up all the way from 2 o'clock in the morning uploading videos, y'all. I was just up 2 o'clock in the morning uploading videos because I just wanted to get it up there. I just wanted to make sure that I get it up there. I didn't want to wait till today because I know I still had a lot to do today. So I'm like, no, I'm just going to upload them tonight. And I did. So, yes, I was up late at night just uploading videos. So, I hope you guys enjoyed the video that I share on how I study the Bible and my shin haul and the morning devotion. The morning devotion, that's the morning devotion for yesterday, but for Wednesday. This is Thursday. And then what else? Beginner's Bible study. Oh, my God. Beginner's Bible study. That was all God. That was God. Like, I really was pushing to get that out there, and it was kind of long, but it was just so much that I really want to make sure that you new beginners, believers in Christ, you know, you just got saved, that you get what you need to get the understanding of how, you know, you're reading the Bible and getting to understand. See, it's a difference when, what God gave me is that it's a difference when you're studying the Bible and you're reading the Bible. When you're reading the Bible, you're just reading through it. When you study in the Bible, you're breaking it down. Like, you read, you see that chapter, you're reading that chapter, but you got your notepad. You got your notepads, and you're like, okay, I want to know more about what this chapter is talking about. So it's like you're going farther. You're going deeper into the chapter. So it's a difference. It's a big difference when you're reading the Bible and you're studying the Bible. When you're reading the Bible, you're just reading through it. You just going through it. You just saying, oh, Matthew and Mark, Matthew, da 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 da. But when you're studying, you say, okay, what did Matthew come from? Who was Matthew? Who was he? That's called you studying. You're studying the Bible. So I just want to put that in there, because when I was uploading it, and it just came to me, like God was just bringing it to my attention, like the difference between when you're, some people, they're just reading through the Bible. But when you're studying, you're learning about the Bible. You're learning about the history of the Bible. You're learning about that chapter. You're learning about who wrote that chapter. You're learning about that. So that's the reason why God wanted me to do the new beginners Bible study, because you're studying it. I am teaching you and showing you how you study. You're not reading. We're not just going through Genesis. We're studying it like chapter by chapter. Like, I read a chapter and then I share with you what that verse is talking about from my study Bible. So I just want to put that in there. You know, there's a big difference when you're reading and when you're studying the Bible. So, but yeah, I pray that you all was blessed by it. And man, your girl, I was exhausted, but I said, this got to get done. I have to do this. So I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to go ahead and read the morning devotion. And another thing I want to add about the beginner's Bible study series that I'm going to be doing is, I'm trying to set a schedule where I will upload the videos where you will see them. Like, I'm thinking about doing it on Wednesday because since that is normally my Bible study, you know, from my church, we do Bible study every Wednesday at 7 o'clock. So I'm thinking that I would just upload the Bible study Wednesday, but upload it, you know, before my Bible study start. I would probably upload it maybe like around noon or something, so you all can get it. And then I'm praying, you know, if God lead me, I'm praying if God lead me to do a live Bible study, because I feel like that if you do a live Bible study, that allows you all to interact with me. They allow you to be like, hey, Melissa, hey, I really enjoyed this Bible study, da 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 da. So I'm going to pray about it, that, and you know, God, have a way, God, lead me. Like, if you want me to do a live, or he might just say, I just want you to stick with just, you know, uploading it, okay? So I'm going to pray about that. And then if anything changed, like if I can't be consistent with it doing it on Wednesday, then I will let you all know. So I just want to share that with you all. Because I was thinking about it and I'm like, what day should I just upload it? And so I'm thinking Wednesday, because since I do Bible study on Wednesday. So that's all, y'all. Well, let me stop talking and let me go ahead and lead us in prayer. Heavenly Father, in the precious mighty name of Jesus Christ, ruler of all things, Lord, we honor you on today. We give you praise and thanks on today for waking us up to see another day. We thank you for the breath of life. We thank you for the activities of our limbs. We thank you for health and strength. We thank you for a roof over our head, food on our table, clothes on our body. Lord, we just thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for helping us to get out the bed this morning. We thank you for health and strength, Lord. We thank you for helping us to see our children off to school. Some of them have already started school early. Lord, we thank you for helping us to see them off this week. Lord, pray and ask that you touch the children and that's getting ready to go back to school. Lord Jesus, there are so many getting prepared to go back to school in this new school year. Lord, I pray and ask that they go back to school. They go back to school, Lord, with a clear mind, a clear mind and an understanding, Lord. That, Lord, that you just cover them with the blood of Jesus, that you protect them from all sins and danger. Lord, that you just help them with their new teachers, with their fellow classmates. Lord, bind the spirit of bullying in the name of Jesus, Lord. Lord, we just pray and ask that you cancel every assignment and attack over our children as they're getting ready to return back to this new school year. Lord, help them in this new school year. Help them with their studies. Help them with their class assignment. Lord, help them to get the grades that they desire to have. Lord, help them, Father, in this new school year. Lord Jesus, Lord, help them. And Lord, help the mothers. Help the mothers. Give them strength, Lord, as they getting prepared. They doing the school shopping. Lord, there are so many. We have single mother. Lord, I pray and ask that you help them, that you meet their needs, Lord. Grant them the resources that they need. Some of them, Lord, don't even have money to get their child the school supplies, the things that they need. Lord, you are a God that answer all things. You are a supplying God. Lord, pray and ask, Lord, that you meet their need, that you send someone to be a blessing to their mother. Send someone to bless her with the funds that she needs, to bless their child with the uniforms, the shoes, the things that they need for their new school year. Lord Jesus, you said, I will not make you ashamed. Lord Jesus, we pray and ask that you grant every student, every child, favor this new school year as they going back. Lord, they go back strong, Lord, that you be with these parents, even the students, the ones they going from kindergarten to first grade to second grade to third grade to fourth grade to fifth grade to sixth grade to seventh grade to eighth grade and even college. Lord, I pray and ask that you be with them in this new school year. And Lord, I pray and ask that you look on your beautiful, lovely peoples on today. Whomever they may be watching this video, I pray and ask that you help them, that you meet their need, that you grant them the healing that they need. If it's sickness in their body, Lord, I pray and ask that you bind sickness in the name of Jesus. Touch them from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet. You are the God that heals from all illness, sickness, and disease, Lord. I pray that you heal right now in the name of Jesus. Lord Jesus, bind every stronghold, every satanic attack in the name of Jesus, Lord. We come against it right now in the name of Jesus. And Lord, I pray and ask that you anoint my mouthpiece on today, that you let flesh decrease as you increase, that you speak words of life, words of encouragement to give to your people to help them, Lord, throughout their workday, their daily tasks, Lord. Help them in their home, Lord Jesus. We pray and ask these things in your mighty name, Jesus. Amen. 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 I just want to pray because we have so many, some of them, some of the children, they're getting ready to go back to school. Just yesterday, my great nephews, they was here, and I was asking them, I said, when do you go back to school? And he said, we go back on the 16th. I said, oh, so they go back next week. So we have some of them, they going back next week. And then my school, we don't go back to the 21st. So I just want to pray that God will be done, you know, in your life, in your children's life, in this new school year. That, you know, this is the new school year, and they go through so much. Like, I work with children, and they go through so much. They go through so much peer pressure, just so much stuff, especially anxiety. So we just pray against it, bind it in the name of Jesus, Lord. We just, and when your children, you get, send them off to school. You know, I know some, we already, just make sure you cover them with the blood of Jesus. Lord, cover them. Cover them as they leaving out these doors. Cover them as they walk into and from school. Cover them with your blood. So, yes, I just want to make sure we pray. We got to pray for our babies. Pray for our babies, y'all. We have to pray for them. Pray that God cover them, protect them in this new school year. Okay, so the morning devotion that I have for today is on speech. Speech. It's on speech, and I want to read you all the definition, because me, I like I say, I like to break things down. I like to just research. I like to know before I deliver something, deliver a message. I like to give you the meaning of it so you know what does that mean. That's what type of person I am. I just like to define things. It's important that you know, so you won't just read through it. So most of the thing, like even when I'm doing devotion, I'm studying, like I'm just doing my research. So speech, one of the definitions read, the expressions of or the ability to express thoughts and feeling by articulate. I'm sorry, y'all. I'm trying to see. Somebody. Articulate sounds, a formal address or discourse delivered to an audience. The Westper definition defines speech as the communication or expression of thoughts in spoken words, in change of spoken words, conversation. Another definition says something that is spoken. So that's I just read you the definition on speech. So now we're going to go into our morning devotion. And again, I'm reading from my 365 days devotion book, and it reads, speech, by your words you will be justified, and by your words you will be condemned. Matthew 12:37. And the morning devotion read, will anyone listen to you talk suspect that you are a believer? If you were accused in court of being a Christian, would there be enough evidence to convict you? That's a good question, y'all. That is a good question. If you were accused in court of being a Christian, would there be enough evidence? Like, will they see the evidence? Me, I would say yes. They will see the evidence. It's because... like the scripture says that, you know, that your light is going to show. The evidence is going to show is how you carry yourself, how you conduct yourself in the courtroom. So the evidence is going to show, the judge is going to see, like, there's something about this person. There's something about this person. Yes, they is a Christ. Yes, they is a Christian. Yes, it's something about this person. They is, you know, they do, they is a child of God. Something about them. Like, they just look different. They look different from any of the other, what is plaintiff that came in my courtroom. I see a difference. This person don't look like that, they're a murderer. This person don't look like they're a thief. This person doesn't look like they committed this crime. You see what I'm saying? So the evidence is going to show, because the way you conduct yourself, the way when you enter that courtroom, when you enter that courtroom, and then they tell you, they may ask you, hey, do you want to say something? Speak, say something on your behalf. So when you open your mouth, when you speak, the evidence is going to show in your speech. Just like our morning devotion, your speech. So the evidence is going to show in your speech. It's going to say, you know what? Yes, he's a man of God. She's a woman of God. She's a child of God. Yes, I don't think she committed this crime. I don't think he committed this crime. You know, the evidence, it shows. So, and then it goes to say that, if you were accused in court of being a Christian, would there be enough evidence to convict you? These queries have been picked out there before, and they are worth thinking about. Are you truthful? Are you reliable and dependable? If your speech, kind and uplifting, using crude, unruly language is a learned habit that can also be unlearned. Do you lift up the name of Jesus or deny him? Do you lift up the name of Jesus? Do you lift up the name of Christ or deny him? It may be scary, but equivalating what you say and how you say it is an important step in determining how deep your commitment to the ways of God are grounded in your life. Be bold. Be bold and take a chance at proclaiming your faith. The next time an inappropriate conversation begins, change the subject. Speak truth. Change the subject. Speak truth and light. Change the subject. Speak truth and light and life and love. When you hear complaining, speak hope and compassion. Be known as someone who is kind. Speak wisely and walk uprightly. A good reputation is priceless. But like I said, like, they would know. It's a song. It says, they would know we are Christian by our love. By our love, by the fruits of the Spirit, they would know. So if you enter into the courtroom, the judge is going to know something different about you. Going to be like, I haven't seen a plaintiff like that. I haven't seen a client, a plaintiff, a defense. I haven't seen one like this. Something about her character is just different. I'm going to tell you about the story when my job where I work at now. And the assistant principal, I was coming down the stairs, and he stopped me and he said something about you. He said something about you. And me, I'm thinking, well, maybe he's thinking because, you know, I wasn't wearing my mask. But that wasn't it. Like, God was just letting me know, that ain't it. Your light. He see your light. There's something different in you. Like, some of them, even on my job, they look at me and they just be like, something different about her. She ain't one of us. She don't talk like us. She don't know. Something different. So it's going to show the way you conduct yourself, the way you carry yourself. It's going to show. People are going to see, like, there's something about you. You a woman of God. Like, you know. I remember, and I know I tell so many stories about my daycare yard, but these are testimonies. So I remember I was working at this daycare center. No, I was went for an interview. I went for an interview, and they do this interview where it's like, they pitch you in the room with the children. They want to see how you act, observation. That's it. They do like an observation on you. So they pit me in the room with these children, and I was there singing the songs and stuff. And so the, what is his name? I think it was the janitor or something. He was walking past, and you know what he said? I was singing a song. You know what he said? He told them, he said, y'all done messed around and got a saved woman up in here. That's what he said. He told them, he said, y'all done messed around and got a saved woman up in here. And all I was doing was singing a song to the children. I was just singing a song. That's it. And I heard him tell the worker, he said, y'all done messed around and got a saved woman up in here. Yes. Yes. So it's going to show. It's going to show. They're going to see your light and the way you present. Soon you step foot in that door, that work, whatever it is, that workplace. Soon you step foot in there, people are going to see like something different about this person. They're a woman of God, they're a man of God, they're a child of God. They're going to see your light is going to show. When you open your mouth, that's going to say the way she talk, the way she talks so godly, you know, that it's going to show. So I just want to share that with you all. And there's a prayer that go with this, and it said, God, help me to speak righteousness. Help me to speak righteousness. Alert me to bad habits and let me offer truth. May others see you in me. And that's the prayer. So this is the morning devotion for today on speech. Speech. And I pray that you all was blessed by this message, this morning devotion on speech. And as you're going about your daily tasks, just know that when you work, you're in the workplace, whatever you're doing, whatever you're doing, you have to conduct yourself in a godly way, like in a godly manner. And that's something like, let me share y'all real quick. The Bible topic that my pastor taught on last night, and it was dealing with moderation. It was dealing with moderation, and I just want to share with y'all some notes. I'm just going to share with y'all some notes, some takeaway, you know, that I got that with my pastor. He was teaching that was beneficial, and the key notes. And he said, watch how we conduct ourselves in this world. Your moderation should be at hand. How to live a godly, controlled life. Doing what God wants me to do. Live a godly life. Remember, he said, remember whom you are. Remember whom you are and who you are. Remember whom you are and who you are. And then he said, we are number one ambassadors for Christ. And when he said that, I was like, that's why God gave me this channel name, Melissa, Ambassador for Christ, because he said, I want you to be my spokesman. I want you to share the good news. I want you to use your channel to share the good news, to draw other souls to me. So this is how I got the channel name Ambassador for Christ. God gave it to me. So when my pastor said this, I was like, confirmation. I was like, confirmation. I'm like, I'm already doing it. I'm already, trying to do the work of the Lord, on my YouTube channel. And then another takeaway that I got was, he said, never forget you are saved and Holy Ghost filled. And you don't have time. He said, you don't have time. Like, you don't have time to play. You don't have time to play around with your salvation. Your salvation is not to be played with. You know, when you're around different other people, you can't compromise your salvation. Somebody, they doing something. He said, I think it's okay. No, don't compromise your salvation. You can't. I remember, and there's another testimony when I was working at the daycare center. And when it came time for Halloween, they would dress up in their costumes and stuff. And so I told my sister, and I'm looking like, they dressing up for Halloween. I'm looking like, I can't do this. And then my spirit just told me, don't compromise. You cannot compromise. You can't compromise with them. So I just wore my scrub, because that's normally what I wear, my scrub, because I work. And I was working in the with the toddlers and then in the nursery. So I just wore my scrub. You can't compromise. You can't. Don't compromise your salvation. You can't. And I could tell you stories on that. Another testimony, when my first job at the daycare center, and I couldn't wear my skirt. They say you have to wear your pants. And so I'm like, oh my God, I'm not going to be able to work. I'm like, I'm not going to be able to work. I'm like, they want me to wear pants. And so this when I first got saved. And like right now, I grew up. Y'all excuse me. I'm going to sip some of this coffee. My breakfast probably done got cold. I got my breakfast right here, but I'm going to eat it when I get done. But, and I was like, oh my God, I'm not going to be able to work. And so, my late pastor at the time, he passed away. My late pastor, he called. He called me because he was trying to reach my sister about something. And he must have felt, he felt it in his spirit. So he called me. He was like, praise the Lord. He was like, are you all right? How you doing? And so I just thank God. My Lord, I thank God for people that are true discerners, like true discerning. Like, I have the gift of discernment, and sometimes God could just, he could just show me something or let me know something is wrong with a person. And we need true discernment. True discernment is that you sitting at home and God reveals something to you about an individual. He might tell you to call them. So I would say my late pastor, he was a true discerner, because I'm sitting at home and I'm looking like, oh, I'm not going to be able to work. And he called me. God had him to call me. He had him to call me, like he was trying to talk to my sister, but God was letting him know something is wrong with Melissa. Something is wrong with her. And so he called me, and then he was like, how you doing? And I'm like, and I said, I'm like, I'm not doing too good. And he was like, what's wrong? And I was like, well, I just started this job. And then they told me that I have to wear my pants. And then he was like, you can wear your pants. He told me, these were his words. He was like, you can wear your pants, but don't compromise. Don't scratch it. Meaning he was like, you wear your pants. Well, he told me, you wear your pants to work. But he said, when you leave work, you get out them pants. You leave work, you get out them pants. And that's what I used to do. I used to go in the bathroom and then I change. And so now as I have grown, now that I have grown in Christ, so what I know, I wear my pants for work, you know, only work for specific reason for work. And then if I'm out somewhere publicly, I have on my skirt. So, and I just want to share that you cannot compromise your salvation. Don't let nobody tell you, oh, it's okay. You can, and that's another thing he was talking about. It's okay. We take wine during the communion anyway. Come on, drink. No. You don't know what they might be putting in there. You might be thinking you're drinking wine and you drinking something else. No. So do not compromise your salvation for no one, for nobody. And let me see. I'm watching my time. And then I'm going to end this. I'm just want to, the takeaways that I got out of the Bible class last night. And I just want to share it with you all. And it said, this walk is all about the legacy of the cross. Everything that you do, every move you make, you are blood bought. You are blood bought. Whatever you do, don't you forget that you are a child of God. Watch as well as pray. Don't let your guys down. So those were some takeaways that from my Bible study on last night that my pastor taught on was moderation. And moderation is like self-control, like having self-control in this walk. So, but that's all I have for you all. I pray that you all was blessed by this morning devotion. Until next time, it's your girl Melissa. Be blessed in Jesus' name.